UK test settlement and citizenship. What do I need to know for the test? You need to know the information contained in the third edition handbook, Life in the United Kingdom, A Guide for New Residents. Every single question in the official test will be based on this book. Test preparation. Question 1. How difficult is the official test? The official test selects 24 randomly generated questions from the database, making every single test unique in terms of difficulty. Our sample tests cover all of the essential facts that you should know for the test, so you can rest assured regardless of the questions that come up in your test. Question 2. What is the difference between different handbooks? The Life in the UK test was last updated in 2013, the third edition update. Consequently, all 2013 to 2020 published handbooks and study guides contain the same information. You don't need to buy a paper copy and can read it online. Question 3. How do we pick the questions? We carefully select questions from the study materials. All of our questions are valid for all exams taking place after 2013 because they are based on the third edition handbook. We aim to provide only the best and most relevant questions to make your preparation pay off in the end. Question 4. Will these questions appear in my official test? Yes and no. The official Life in the UK test is a selection of randomly selected questions from their own database. Our questions are designed to be similar to those in the official test. They might actually come up. You will be surprised how easy it is to pass your official test after completing our tests. Tips for the test. Take your time to watch and answer the questions. It's important to pay attention to the question and watch it as many times as you need to make sure that you understand it correctly. You are allowed 45 minutes to complete the test. That is just under 2 minutes per question. Pay attention to the type of question asked. Some questions will have more than one correct answer. In such cases, make sure that you select as many correct options as the question asks. What to expect at the test center? How long will I spend at the test center? Make sure to give yourself a 2-hour slot for the test. We advise you to arrive 15 minutes early to be on the safe side. The identity checks should take another 15 minutes and you will be given 45 minutes to complete the test. Additionally, if you choose to do a practice test to familiarize yourself with the test format, you will need even more time. The waiting time for the result is usually less than 5 minutes and you will be able to leave the test center upon receiving your pass or fail certificate. Identity checks. This is a standard procedure operated by every approved test center. You will be required to show the identification used when booking the test and show the true likeliness of the person displayed on the ID. Can I bring visitors guests? Not all test centers will allow visitors guests. However, you will be able to bring guests to the British citizenship ceremony. What happens if I pass? Upon passing the Life in the UK test, you will receive a pass certificate. This certificate has no expiry date and can be used for all future applications. What happens if I fail? If you fail the Life in the UK test, you will need to wait at least 7 days before booking another test. You can take unlimited attempts for this test, however, every single attempt will cost you £50. It is highly advised to read the study materials and complete practice tests to pass first time. Common mistakes and issues. Wrong place of birth. It is strongly advised to make sure that you specify the correct place of birth. In some cases, candidates were not allowed to sit the test after incorrectly stating their place of birth, e.g., stating the city instead of country. First name and last name are wrong way round. Make sure that you look out for first name and last name fields. The booking service asks for your last name and then your first name. If you mix up your first and last last names, you may not be able to sit the test or get the money back. Passport has identity and passport number. If your passport has both the identity number and passport number, make sure that you enter your passport number when booking the test. Lost my life in the UK test pass certificate. You'll need to contact the Home Office on 03001-232-253 about your lost pass certificate. Make a complaint about the life in the UK test. To make a complaint about the test, you should contact Learn Direct, the company which administers the tests. You can contact him using email, complaints@litup.learndirect.com, or call 0800-015-4245, Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Note that calls might be charged. Additionally, you should fill in the following form if you wish to get a refund. Complaint. You'll get a response within 10 working days. All complaints must be submitted within 3 months of the test date. Using this channel. How should I use this channel to get ready for the test? Since the Life in the UK test is based on the 3rd edition handbook, we strongly suggest you read and understand the material before attempting our practice test. Our practice tests are designed to teach you the material interactively. They cover every single paragraph of the handbook and contain explanations of the correct answer. Completing all practice tests effectively familiarizes you with the type of questions that may come up in your test and covers the whole handbook. Most people pass their test after completing just 10-15 practice tests, but we strongly advise you to complete all. When do I know that I'm ready? You should be ready after completing all practice tests. If you pass them all, rest assured that you will find the final exam easy.